for the students. Now, the question answers, they are being displayed on your screens. We have completed the chapter, My Childhood Yesterday, and now we are going to start the discussion of the question answers. So, those who want to give the answer, as you know, you have to just raise up your hands and give the answers, right? So that we can have the complete idea of the answers. First is, where was Abdul Kalam's house? Yes, Ramneet. I have unmuted Ramneet, Dia.
Yes, ma'am. Abdul Kalam's house was on the Moss Street in the Rameshwaram.
His house was situated in the Moss Street of Rameshwaram. So what kind of house it was? It was an ancestral house. This is just additional information that I am giving you. It was an ancestral house which was built in the early 19th century. And what it was made up of? It was made up of limestone and brick. Next. Second question is, what do you think Dina Mani is the name of, and give a reason for your answer? Yes, Ashpreet?
Dina Mani seems to be the name of a newspaper. Kalam mentions that he gathered information about the World War from his brother-in-law Jalaluddin. Later, he tried to trace these stories in the headlines of Dina Mani. Headlines are titles of news items. So, Dina Mani must be a newspaper.
So, what's the name of Dina Mani? Dina Mani is the name of the newspaper which was being circulated in Rameshwaram. So, Abdul Kalam, as he has got news about Second World War from his cousin Jalaluddin, and later on he was tracing those news in the newspaper. So, this is the name of the newspaper. Next. Who were Abdul Kalam's school friends and what did they later become? Yes, Dia, you can give the answer.
Abdul Kalam had three close friends in his childhood. They were Ramanand Shastri, Arvinda and Shiva Prakashan. All these boys were from orthodox Hindu Brahmin families. Later in life, they turned out to be very successful. Ramanand Shastri was the son of Pakshi Lakshman Shastri, the highest priest of Rameshwaran temple, and he later took over his priesthood from his father. Arvinda went into the business of arranging transport for visiting pilgrims, and Shiva Prakashan became a catering contractor for Southern Railways.
Yes, absolutely right. So, who were the three friends? Abdul Kalam shared his childhood with three friends named Ramanand Shastri, Arvindam and Shiv Prakashan. Ramanand Shastri was the son of the highest priest of Rameshwaram temple. So after his father, he has taken over the priesthood of his father. Arvindam, he went into the business of arranging transport for the pilgrims to Rameshwaram temple, and Shiv Prakashan, he undertook the business of a contractor, or worked as a contractor for Southern Railways, catering contractor for Southern Railways. Absolutely right. Now, next afterwards, how did Abdul Kalam earn his first wages?
Abdul Kalam earns his first wages by distributing newspapers.
So you will have to give the complete idea. So during World War II, when India joined Allied forces, they declared an emergency, and because of this, the halt at Rameshwaram temple was suspended. So his cousin Shamsuddin, he needed a person who would catch the bundle of newspapers that had to be thrown between Dhansukodi and Rameshwaram, as there was nobody else. So APJ Abdul Kalam, he filled the slot, and ultimately what happened? He has earned his first wages. So had he earned his wages earlier also? That was not any professional one.
He earned in the form of selling tamarind seeds when yes. their demand rose.
When the Second World War, there was sudden demand of tamarind seeds. So he used to gather those tamarind seeds and would sell at a provision shop.
Provision shop on Moscow Street.
And after that, what he used to get, he would get a princely amount of an anna. Right? So, had he earned any money before? This I have told you. So, next is second part. How does the author describe his father, his mother, and himself? So, how does author has described his father? Yes, Panika can answer.
Yes, ma'am. Hmm. The author described the Abdul Kalam's father that his father name was Janulabdin was not a wealthy or educated person. However, he was an honest and generous man who possessed great innate wisdom. He was self-disciplined and avoided all inessential luxuries. He described his mother as, his mother name was Ashima. He was an ideal helpmate to her husband. She believed in goodness and profound kindness. It fed many people every day. And next, the author described himself as a short boy with undistinguished looks, who had a secure childhood. He's an honest and self-disciplined person who believes in goodness and deep kindness.
So, you have to actually, this question, it is actually in the form of, for example, character sketches. Okay? So, what you have to write down, his father, Janulabdin, was not so educated, but he was born with innate wisdom. He was not able to gather enough wealth, but he had the quality of discriminating right and wrong. It means that he had good sense of wisdom and he knew how to bring up his children. Right? Moreover, he was austere in nature. Austere in nature means that he was not giving importance to the luxuries, but the basic requirements or the basic necessities of life. And when Abdul Kalam, he has decided to go to Ramananthapuram in order to pursue his education, and it was only his father who has supported him. His father, even her mother, understand that even a seagull, it has to leave its nest in order to fetch food. And moreover, he is a learned man. Because as he has given the example of Khalil Gibran words also, that although you are the medium of giving birth to your children, but this doesn't mean that you will give your own thoughts to them. They have their own thoughts and they have their own, you can say, own feeling and own aspirations. And it is just because of this reason, they have their own life and they have to go anywhere they want. He has also inherited great qualities from his father. For example, he has inherited honesty, self-discipline from his father, humility, as well as endurance. So these are some of the qualities which he learned from his father. And moreover, his father has a deep impact in the development of his personality. And it is just from his father that he has learned various things. So he respects his father a lot, although he was not so educated. So his mother Ashima was a compatible partner to that of his father, Janulabdin. She is also kind and generous, as she used to feed number of people from outside the family in their house. And it is just because of her belief in karma and her faith in goodness. She is an embodiment of deep kindness. It is just because of her kindness that she is always helping others. And moreover, she is greatly in love with APJ Abdul Kalam, and it is just because of this reason that when he decided to go for higher education to Ramanathapuram, she was a bit hesitant. Now, Abdul Kalam, from this chapter, we have come to know that Abdul Kalam has learned many qualities from his father. He is, of course, humble in his nature, honest, and self-disciplined. These qualities he has learned from his father. And from his mother, he has learned faith in goodness as well as deep kindness. He has never discriminated. He is always against communal intolerance. And this is the reason why he had friendship with Brahmin boys who belong to Orthodox Brahmin families. Now, after that, he is always standing against the obstacles. As Subramaniam Iyer, his science teacher, has ignited the spirit in his personality that he should always stand against odds, and he should always stand against difficult paths. And this is the reason why he stood against it and wanted to finish this kind of discrimination. He was quite worried about his future. For this is the reason why he wanted to, when he completed his education in Rameshwaram, he wanted to attain education in Ramanathapuram. And as I told you that she was filled with humility when his science teacher's wife, Subramaniam Iyer's wife, she was not ready to serve him in her kitchen, which was pure. He did not stand against that, but ultimately it was just because of her sense that she came to know that there is no difference between a Hindu as well as a Muslim boy. So she actually, Abdul Kalam, he wanted to finish all kind of differences that prevails in the society. He wanted to overcome these kind of differences that prevails in the society. So it is just because of this reason that since childhood, he has learned many qualities which made him an impeccable personality. Right? Impeccable means impressive. Next, what characteristics does he say he inherited from his parents? This I have completely told in this answer that Abdul Kalam, he has inherited various qualities from his parents. So what he has told that he has learned humility, love towards human beings, that is benevolence, honesty. He has learned a self-discipline from his father. And from his mother, he has inherited faith in goodness and kindness. And it is not only Abdul Kalam who has inherited these qualities from his parents, but along with his other brothers and sisters who have also inherited these qualities from the parents. So it means that these qualities are actually in the air of the family. It was actually in the air, and ultimately just because of this reason that they have inherited these qualities from their parents. So I hope that it is clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Next one. Okay. Next is, discuss these questions in class with your teacher and then write down the answers in 2 to 3 paragraphs. It means long answers. So the first one is, on the whole, the small society of Rameshwaram was very rigid in terms of the segregation of different social groups, says the author. Which social groups does he mention, and were these groups easily identifiable, for example, the way they dressed? Yes.
Social groups like religious communities and different sections of society. For example, the society is divided into Brahmins, Kshatriyas, which is in an Orthodox division. They are easily identifiable because Muslims usually wear a cap, whereas Hindus wear a sacred thread around their chest.
So you can say that different different kind of social groups are mentioned in this chapter. For example, Brahmins as well as Muslims. Right? These groups were easily identifiable. Yes. These groups were easily identifiable because of the kind of dress they were wearing. As when the new teacher has entered into the school, he has easily identified APJ Abdul Kalam or Abdul Kalam from the kind of cap that he was wearing, which was completely differentiating him from that of the Brahmin family. And it means, moreover, during various ceremonies, during Ram Tirath ceremony, he has said that all the Hindu families were involved in this ceremony, and moreover, his family was equally involved. So he has also given an example of communal harmony in this chapter. Right? Next question is, were they aware only of their differences, or did they also naturally share friendship and experience? What do you say?
No, they were not only aware of their differences, but also they naturally shared friendships and experiences. Kalam's mother and grandmother would tell the children of his family bedtime stories about the events from the Ramayana and from the life of Prophet. During the Sri Sita Rama Kalyanam ceremony, his family used to arrange boats with a special platform for carrying idols of the Lord from the temple to the marriage site situated in the middle of the pond called Rama Tirtha, which was near his house.
Yes, exactly. This is what I want to listen. So, yes, there existed the differences, but the people were mingled with each other that they never tried to identify and reveal these differences. It is just because of this reason that as there did not exist any kind of differences, that Abdul Kalam, he has shared or he has developed a strong bond of friendship with three other friends named Ramanand Shastri, who was the son of the highest priest of Rameshwaram temple, which belongs to Hindu religion, Arvindam and Shivprakashan. And all the three were from Orthodox Brahmin family. And they all shared friendship. So this is the example that how they shared friendship. Moreover, Abdul Kalam shared his first seat in the classroom with Ramanand Shastri, as there was not any discrimination between them. Apart from which, in the various ceremonies and rituals which were related to Hindu ceremonies, in Muslim people, they were also equally taking part. For example, he has cited the example here during Sita Ram Kalyanam ceremony, when the people have to carry the idols of Lord Rama to the center of the pond. Abdul Kalam's family was equally or enthusiastically he was involved in order to arrange the boats so that the people could put the idols on the platform and could take to the center of the pond, right? And after that his grandmother, she was also not at all discriminating. It means people were not discriminating, as Abdul Kalam's bedtime stories, it consisted of stories from the life of Lord Rama as well as that of the Prophet. So it means that they were giving equal importance to both the religions. This is not the only example. One more example is given, that when the new teacher in an elementary school entered, and he discriminated Hindu and Muslim and told Abdul Kalam to sit at the last seat. And at that moment, what he has told, both the children, they have forwarded this matter to their parents, and ultimately Ramanand Shastri called and rebuked the teacher in front of the children and told him to leave the island or to leave this kind of communal and not to spread communal intolerance and not to sow the seeds of poison. So this is, you can say, clearly exemplifying, and moreover, it is clearly describing that people were not at all differentiating themselves on the basis of religion and on the basis of different social groups. Right? So The next answer, the author speaks both of people who were very aware of the differences among them and those who tried to bridge these differences. Can you identify such people in the text?
The new school teacher and Sivas Brunmaniam Ayer's wife was very aware.
So his, you can say, school teacher who has entered the school during his elementary school when he was studying in class 5th, he tried to build differences between them by separating Hindus and Muslims from each other. Later on, with the help of Ramanand Shastri, Ramanand Shastri's father, Pakshi Lakshman Shastri, he was controlled and he was also scolded for not spreading the seeds of communal intolerance among children. Moreover, his science teacher, Subramaniam Iyer, was trying to bridge this gap as he has invited Abdul Kalam to his house for dinner. Although he belonged to Orthodox Brahmin family and his wife, who thought his kitchen to be you can say completely pure, she was not at all allowing and not ready to allow a Muslim boy to enter her kitchen. But he was a sort of rebel who stood against those set beliefs and wanted to bridge the gap between those differences. And he was quite successful and has taught Abdul Kalam a lesson that if he want to change the setup of the society, he will face many kind of obstacles and he has to overcome these obstacles in life. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Next, narrate two incidents that show how differences can be created and how they can be resolved. So both these examples can be given here, right? Which I have given. Both these examples, how differences created by the teacher in the elementary school and how these differences can be bridged. The same one I have told of Subramaniam Iyer. So both can be written. Next is second question. Why did Abdul Kalam want to leave Rameshwaram? Why he wanted to leave Rameshwaram?
Abdul Kalam wanted to leave Rameshwaram because he wanted to pursue his studies and achieve higher.
He wanted to pursue his higher studies at Ramanandpuram, at the headquarters of Ramanandpuram. Why at the headquarters of Ramanandpuram? It is because of the reason that after the World War, okay, when India joined Allied forces, right? So at that time, what is there that the whole country was filled with an unprecedented spirit of making their own country. So it is just because of this reason that he wanted to pursue his dreams, he wanted to continue his education, right? So next one.
Yes.
What did his father say to this? What did his father say to this? His father, who understood his feelings and he knew that even, and he was not at all reluctant to send Abdul Kalam for higher studies. Moreover, he has given an example of seagull, that even a seagull can leave its nest to go alone near the sun to fetch the food. Moreover, he has also cited the words of Khalil Gibran and said that his children are actually your children. They are not the sons and daughters of, they are not the son, they are the sons and daughters of life's longing. Okay, the aspirations which we have for us. Okay, we are the reason to give birth to them. We are the mode or we are the medium to bring them into this world. But this does not mean that they will always follow our thoughts. Moreover, what he has said that, he has told his mother that we can give them love, but we cannot give them thoughts. They have their own thoughts and they have to follow their own thoughts. So next is, what do you think his words mean and why he spoke these words? So it means that everyone has a right to pursue and do whatever he wants in life. The thing is that the condition is that the path should be the right one. Okay. And why he wanted to make his wife understand the reason that it is one week that they cannot bound Abdul Kalam. They would never wanted to stop him back, but ultimately there should be a bridge for him in order to move forward in his life. And with this, the discussion is over for all the question answers. After giving for speech writing, one day I will devote one lecture for the question answers of extra question answers of this chapter. So I hope that everything is clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, fine. So with this, we are going to wind up today, and tomorrow we will start with speech writing also.